Picture's worth a thousand words. You've all heard that saying. You haven't heard it in math. But it's absolutely true. So in math, we often have a bunch of problems that have to do with pictures. Somebody draws a graph, and here's a function. Okay, and they might ask you a question like, what's the area under the curve between A and B? Or they might ask you, what's the slope of the tangent line at C? Or maybe, what's the equation of the tangent line right there? And you're probably thinking, who cares? I mean, I have never walked down the street and seen a curve and said, I wonder how much area there is under that curve, or I wonder what the slope of that tangent line is. It's just not an interesting question. There are lots of things in the real world that you do want to keep track of that are described by pictures. So let's suppose that you've got a business and you plot your yearly profits of that business. And let's say this is 2003, and this is 2007, and this is 2011. And you might say, well, then the picture has meaning. What does it mean to be way up here? It means you were having a really good year. What does it mean to be down here below zero? It means you were losing money. What was happening over here? Well, you weren't making as much money as you were at the peak, but you were on your way up. Things were getting better. Things weren't very good at this time. Things were very good at this time. You were on your way up. It was pretty steep. What about down here? Well, it was pretty steep on the in the downhill direction. That was the Great Recession. Started in 2008. And things bottomed out in 2009 and came back up. And if you want to have a prediction about what's going to happen next year, if you want to predict what's happening next year, you're going to say, hey, we're heading off in this direction. So our best guess your best guess of where things are going is you take the slope right now and you just extend it with a line. And if you want to make, here we are in 2012. And if you want to know where you're going to be in 2013, you extrapolate. Well, that's following a tangent line. So suddenly, all of these abstract mathematical ideas, area under a curve, slope of the tangent line, equation of the tangent line, actually mean something. The area under the curve between 2003 and 2007 is how much money you made between 2003 and 2007. The slope of the curve was the trend. Things were, the trend was really good here. It was really bad here. Right now, it's so-so. The height of the curve is, are you doing well? Are you losing money? So questions of geometry can help you with questions of the real world, but only if you draw a picture of what's happening in the real world.